Welcome back, my duelist friends. Casual Duelist here with
Celestial Duelist, guys.
And it's time for round two of our three times tournaments. Now, for those of you keeping track with your scorecards at home, Yugi moved on. Today we will be playing Strings versus Mako. She has given me the slime god. She has decided she wants the last tournament winner. So, that said, do you want to roll some more dice? Or do you just want to pick because the last match did not go in your favor?
No, we'll roll dice.
All right, cool. High or low?
Let's go high.
Okay, and is the winner going first or second?
Winner goes first.
All right, I got a four. You got a one. Why do you keep rolling ones?
I don't know. Because it's just the way of the luck.
It is what it is. Let's give this a couple, you know, on-screen shuffles. This way they can't go, well, they stacked it. No, we didn't.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
We aren't going to cheat at a children's card game because that would take all the fun of the children's card game out.
Exactly, especially since we're just casual players.
Well, I only play casually now. I used to be a competitive player, so.
I remember.
No, that was just a little bit before you. I used to go to regional events and such.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going first, right? That's
yes.
What we decided.
Yep.
My skill flips over when activated, so I'm going to need four cards. Now, the only thing I don't like about this is the only deck in our tournament that actually required a foil. So, unfortunately, the way that I draw, I kind of flex the cards a little bit. I'll know when I hit the god card because of it. And, or I won't.
So,
guys, I'm going to throw a defense and pass my turn.
Okay.
So that's you, Celestial.
Good. My turn.
I'm
draw.
Try to open my soda without making too much noise.
Okay. I will activate my field spell, Umi.
Oh, cool.
So.
That unfortunately helps me out as well.
So I will summon out the seven colored fish.
Very big. Very disgusting 2,000 points of power because of power up. What else you got?
I will leave that card face down in my back row.
Okay.
And I will enter my battle phase and I will swing on you.
All right. So you're going to find Mother Grizzly.
Of course.
Yeah. So since it was destroyed by battle, I get to special summon a water attribute 1500 or less from my deck. Luckily, he's at the bottom of my deck. And correct me if I'm wrong, aquas get a power up here too from your field spell?
All fish, sea serpents.
Please don't show me your hand.
Thunder and aqua monsters, yes, on the field gain 200 attack.
All right, people, it's a 700 point slime.
Woo.
Let's go.
So,
I just wanted to see if he got power up.
Yeah.
I knew the grizzly didn't because she's a beast warrior.
Yeah.
But under legendary ocean, she would.
Right. So.
All right. So you ready for the strategy of this deck?
Okay. Let's go.
Okay. So you're ending your turn?
Yeah. I'm going to end my turn.
Okay. I'll draw. I will activate the effect of my card. So I've got spare cards sitting over here, which is going to take two. Place them face down. So once per turn, the reactor slime may activate its first ability during the main phase. You can activate this, special summon two slime tokens. Also, level one aqua, 500 by 500. So they're also 700s.
Mm-hmm.
They cannot be normal summon, or I cannot normal summon or special summon, except for divine beast monsters.
Right.
And then I don't use the rest of the effect because like metal reflect slime was not part of the main deck for this, so there was no way for me to incorporate it. But he does have another cool play that's like totally valid elsewhere.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to do that so I can go ahead and have my three offerings.
Yeah.
For the ancient Egyptian god card that started the game in my hand.
Lovely.
And again, three cards in hand means 3,000 power.
Yeah.
You remember Slifer's second mouth attack, right?
Yes.
All right, so you understand how everything's going to work from here on out.
Mm-hmm.
I'll enter the battle phase, and we'll go ahead for 1,000 points.
Okay.
Your turn.
Right. Draw. So. All right. So.
Why do I have a feeling you're going to be taking the slime deck in the secondary round of the tournament?
I probably will. But I will be activating Fortress Whale's Oath.
Okay, cool, cool.
So,
do you have the ritual monster in your hand? And also the amount of offerings that you need?
I don't have the monster in hand, no.
Okay, so it's been a while since you played rituals. It. Yeah, yes, you have to have it all in hand, or technically the offerings can come from the field too, but they have to be your own side of the field unless you have card effects that allow you to take over your opponent's monsters.
Okay.
So like the one card that was face down, I had Snatch Steal over here. Like you could take my card that way and then use it as part of your offerings.
Yeah. Okay.
Kind of goofy, right?
Yeah, it's kind of goofy.
Look, I mean, if this is it for the round one, I get it. Slifer's a strong play.
It's going to have to be the end.
Okay, so that's round one of it.
Yep, because that's what I had. Because I just gained him.
Yeah, the Air Orca would be cool, except Slifer already being on the field will zap him off with the effect.
Right. So
I had a Jam Defender and two Revival Jams in my hand, so not so bueno.
Yeah.
But it would have been fine. There was actually a way with the strength skill. You remember. Mm-hmm. I can force you to attack the... well, I have the Jam Defender. So, like, you go ahead, you try to attack into the God card and stuff.
I could have activated my...
Yeah, but you still would have lacked your number for tributes. You still have to discard to activate.
Right.
So then you'd have to have that many stars in the one other card in your hand. And I built the deck. It didn't have it.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Okay. And with Slifer anyways, I still would have lost.
Now, there is one way in your deck, and we'll see if you can draw it out, that you can stop Slifer from getting to the field.
So.
But it is looking like it might be Yugi versus Strings in the second, what do you want to call that? We're already in the quarterfinals, so it'd be the semifinals before finals, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, very cool, very nice. I'm thinking maybe you planned that way, didn't you?
What? No.
Yeah, I think that's why you played Arcana. You wanted Dark Magician to move forward with Yugi.
So, all right. Well, since I lost, I would like to go first.
Sounds good.
So, okay. All right, face down card, and I will summon out the seven colored fish.
Ah, homie's back.
Homie's back.
All right.
And I will end my turn.
All right, I'll draw. I will throw one down and one back row and end my turn.
Okay, I shall, oops. Draw a card. I got this turned around.
I know. I don't like it when that happens.
Okay. Lay down a face down back row. Summon out the Air Orca. And I will enter my battle phase. I will use the Air Orca first. I know it's Mother Grizzly. Oh, it's a Revival Jam this time.
When it's destroyed, I'll pay my 1,000.
Okay.
Strike. Can I flip this, or is this only during my main phase? See, this is one of those things where I'm not so sure, because I do want to get the effect to draw three.
It's once per turn during your main phase.
No, I get that. No, that's for the first bit.
Yeah.
That's where you can destroy a jam breeding machine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to flip it. I'm going to say that I can still get to do my draw three.
Okay. Even though it's my
During my next turn when the Revival Gem comes back.
Ah, okay. All right. And then I'm going to use...
Oh, no. I still got to take that 18 plus the 1,000 I paid.
Yep.
It's 28. I'm going to be down to 1,200.
Okay.
And it's just I want some cards.
And then I'll end my turn.
I'm going to cheat a little bit. So we'll draw standby phase. He comes back. He says it has to be defense position.
Mm-hmm.
And then Slippery Slimes will let me get in a few more cards. Since we're still during the standby phase, I could probably activate this. This way, each time I draw a card, I gain 500 life points. Now, if I was smarter, I would have done it during the end of your turn instead of during my standby phase when I draw for the slimy slimes.
Yeah.
So I could have gained back 1,000 of the damage I took.
Mm-hmm.
But I wasn't that smart. So.
No.
There is that.
Yeah.
Once per turn, we can destroy a jam breeding machine, right? So I'll play one to pop your card behind Aero Orca.
Does it go to my graveyard or
yeah,
my hand?
Yeah, they both do. They both go away.
You stinker!
I mean,
but
you don't have
okay.
Umi right now, so technically you snuffed my effect.
That's true.
I mean, if we're going to do that.
True.
Also, let's maybe do like a whole back row.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I don't know. We will summon Mother Grizzly.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll go ahead, we'll enter battle phase, and we'll go Grizzly to Air Orca. 14v14.
Yeah.
They'll both go to the discard pile.
Yep.
And this will allow me to summon out another Mother Grizzly from my deck.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so I'm only at 1,700 hit points.
Yeah.
This is going to be very tight for me this time if I'm going to try to win.
Right.
Would you like to go ahead and give that a cut?
Yeah, I'll cut it for you.
All right. I still have 4 cards in my hand, and that's going to be the end of my turn. So it's Grizzly in attack mode with Jam and Defense, Solemn Wishes up,
okay,
and one back row. All
right, I draw. I'll summon out my other 7 color fish. I will enter my battle phase.
Of course you do.
I will take out the Mother Grizzly with this one, and then
I will activate the Jam Defender. So all it means is, like, the first attack gets drawn to the Revival Jam anyway, so I can pay the 1,000.
Yeah.
So this way I can bring back the Revival Jam again this next turn?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And then I'm going to use... One of them attacks the Mother Grizzly, then.
Okay, so that'll be 400. So from 17, I'll go down to 13.
Mm-hmm.
And we get to go ahead with the Grizzly effect. Which means we are going to need to read our reactor slime really, really well.
Yeah.
Well, because on the one hand, reactor slime, if it says 2, summoning that and getting the revival jam back actually blocks me from getting to where I want to go.
Uh-huh.
And that is exactly how it works. So, we are just going to play another Mother Grizzly
mm-hmm.
for the time being. And I will give you the deck to try to cut again. What is that cut? Show them. Do that on camera.
Okay. All right, guys.
Show them what you were doing.
See, what I did is because somebody revealed one of his secrets. So I kind of, because you said.
Revealed a secret?
Because the slifer in your deck.
Oh, so what you're doing is you're feeling up the cards and bending them slightly to try to cheat. Got it. You heard her, guys.
I'm not
she's
trying
cheating.
To cheat.
She's cheating.
I just.
She's not trying. She's doing. No, it's fine. I just thought it was funny because you were like, you separate. I'll take those ones. I'll put one here. I'll take this middle one to the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was funny.
So.
All right, so I'm at 14, right?
Yeah. Or is it?
No, 13.
13.
And that was your 2 attacks.
Yes.
It's my turn.
Yeah.
We'll draw, gain this. I'll go up to 18. Then during the standby phase, I'm going to draw more cards when the revival jam comes back.
Yes.
And that'll take me up to 23, but I'll have to draw 3 more cards. I've got so much of my deck right now. It's not even funny.
Right.
So let's go with a jam breeding machine to destroy your back row. I'll play it and then use the skill. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We'll lock in infinite cards. This way at the end of this turn, I don't have to discard anything.
Right.
And then... Man, I really don't like you right now. No, it's fine. It's fine.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Let's see what this is. I can. So it doesn't mean I have to. I will summon a revival jam in attack mode.
Okay.
And that will be the end of my turn. See, the jam defender is actually optional. I could just choose not to have one of them intercede.
All right. I will draw. Okay. I'm going to flip over my skill.
All right, so we're discarding a card to add a piece of the puzzle.
Yes.
Which piece are you going? Are you going spell or monster?
The monster.
Fantastic.
So. Which will be fine because then I can activate.
Yeah, Fortress Whale's Oath. Okay, so you're taking out both fish?
Yeah, I'm going to take out both fish.
Okay, and what were the benefits given to the Fortress Whale through this skill?
My opponent cannot target face-up water monsters I control with spell or trap card effects.
Okay.
So. Alright, so I'm going to enter my battle phase. And I'm going to take out... There's one of her already. I'm going to take out... This guy. Your revival jam.
Now, real quick, I'm going to count my deck. I have 5 cards. I will choose to not use Jam Defender to move it to the other jam because that'd be silly. I'll pay life points to go down to 1,300 so that I can revive that jam this next round.
Okay.
Is that it?
Yeah, that'll have to end my turn.
Okay, so essentially, I'm going to draw all but the one card of my deck because I'm going to draw one normally, 3 abnormally. I have 3 monsters on my side of the field. I have drawn 19 of the cards of my deck, which means I actually have all 3 slifers in my hand.
Dang it!
So when I tribute these 3, I have 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, 8,000, unfortunately. And that is going to take game 2.
Yep. So
because big bad 8K Slifer.
And because my fish step charge.
You figured it out. You did. You figured it out.
I did. But.
So let him know. Let him know how you could have stopped this using the deck.
If he hadn't taken out my trap card.
No, just tell us how you use it.
Fish step charge. Tribute 1 fish monster, then I target 1 card on the field. Destroy that target, and if I do, I draw a card.
Now, what is your optimal targets?
Well, optimal targets would have been, like, Slifer.
Yeah, because unlike Obelisk, he can be targeted.
Yes.
Obelisk is the only one of the ancient Egyptian god cards that cannot be targeted by card effects. It is not a, for the one, it is not a, like, a once per turn, or only on the turn it is summoned. Additionally, you know that I love to use Mother Grizzly to go into the, the reactor slime?
Yes.
So, when you see the reactor slime, it's easy if you've already thrown the depth charge down.
Yes.
You just wait till my turn. You can even get me after I do the effect to spawn tokens. Or you just go like, oh, you drew, cool. I'm going to go ahead and pop the slime and you got to start from square one again.
Yep, but... You had already taken it out in the second and the
yeah. I ended up with all the breeding machines, so
you did.
I was able to use slimy slimes to go ahead and hit the back row.
Darn! I thought I could have decked you out with
almost.
Almost. You were down to 1 card there.
But so that's round 2.
Yep.
Strings versus Yugi is now official, not just in the show. That is something that's going to happen later on in the tournament. Again, guys, we enjoyed doing this for you. We hope that you guys enjoyed watching it. Thank you for stopping by. We hope to see you guys again next time. And be on the lookout. We are getting that structure deck later this week. So hopefully we'll have some fun with that as well. See you later.
Later.